Welcome to FP Executive. I'm here with Dan Tisch from Argyle Communications. How are you today, Dan?
I'm doing just great.
Dan, you are an optimist. I read your piece, which is in our paper, FP Executive, and you're looking at our current troubled times as an opportunity to get some market share for companies that are working or reworking their budgets for 2009 for ad buys. This is a time when they might actually be able to grow their market, and I found that intriguing. Can you explain how you came to this conclusion?
Sure. Well, I guess, you know, our firm has been advising Canadian companies on their public relations and marketing strategies for close to 30 years, and we've seen more than a few recessions and economic slowdowns. And I guess as part of that, we've observed over time that when tough times hit, you can see executives divide into three camps.
Okay.
You know, there's those who become very timid, so they'll just pare back their marketing budgets instinctively, you know, to save money. There are those who are uncertain. They'll just kind of become paralyzed and they'll postpone critical decisions that they may need to make into the future. Mm-hmm. And then there are those who are bold, who are going to see their competitors' timidity or indecision as an opportunity to grab market share. Mm-hmm. And I guess my point of view is that it's better to be in that bold camp, not necessarily by doing things that are risky, but by doing things that are smart.
It's interesting. I mean, the challenge is obviously to try and identify what is smart as opposed to what really in the end is going to be risky. And I know that you did your MBA at Queen's, for example. Have you studied this sort of marketing and risk management closely when you were at Queen's? Is that something that you specialized in when you were there?
Well, it won't surprise you that I was focused on marketing
when
I was at Queen's. But, you know, yeah, I mean, Queen's, fantastic school. You know, we use the case study method, and it was really interesting because you got an appreciation of different types of companies, from the small and entrepreneurial, you know, the anatomy of a startup and what happens, as well as gigantic multinational corporations like Xerox or General Motors or others that are in the news these days, and the decisions that they have to make. And what I really find is that no matter whether you're big or small, no matter what sector you're in, when it comes to marketing and communications, and particularly public relations, there are just a few things that you got to think about. And I think in these economic times, the key is thinking about strategies and tactics that are both nimble and scalable. Nimble meaning you can turn quickly, you can change direction quickly, you can keep your options open, and scalable so that you can start small if you need to, but grow over time.
I see. Well, it sounds to me the trick here is identifying what's risk and what's going to grow your market share. What are you advising your clients right now in terms of, you know, you want to be bold? What's an example of being bold? Do you have any, you know, cases that we can think about?
Well, I guess what I'd say is, you know, if you think about an earned media strategy versus a paid media strategy, that's an important decision that people have to make.
Okay.
And I think that there's a lot of logic to thinking about public relations leading advertising. So start with public relations. A public relations budget is typically 10 to 15% of an advertising budget, and it can be developed and executed far more quickly, often with great bang for the buck. So, you know, let me give you an example.
Okay.
You know, TD Bank very recently announced a partnership with the Children's Miracle Network, really successful corporate social responsibility type initiative, and they helped to publicize this really good cause and their involvement in it by doing a poll about Canadians' charitable giving habits and how the current economy would affect Canadians' charitable giving. The good news is Canadians, by the way, are still going to give. You know, but it was very interesting to tap into that. That was very interesting to media. And so that created an opportunity to get some profile for this really important cause very, very quickly. That the cost of doing that and the time to market of that strategy to communicating a story, the cost is low and the timing is really fast.
Right? So unlike
a traditional ad buy, which would be very expensive and take a long time to execute.
So let me unpack this then for some of our viewers who may not be familiar with the whole ad buy scene. So this case that you're giving us, rather than, for example, going out and doing television commercials for several days extolling the virtues of this particular charity, what you had was an example of doing a poll about charitable giving where you essentially generate some interesting news for the, that the newspapers will pick up. And the poll is done in the context of giving information about or drawing attention to this charity. Is that essentially how it works?
It is, yeah. And the thing is, you know, a poll is a time-honored tactic.
Right.
You know, a lot of people are doing them. They're a dime a dozen, especially in the financial industry.
Mm-hmm.
But you can still get a lot of attention from research. If it's intelligent and if you tap into something which other people aren't doing, right? So
right.
It's got to have something unique. As you know, being a journalist, you know, the test is it something which is going to communicate a story in a fresh and interesting way?
Right.
But there are lots of other tactics. Social media is another tactic that's increasingly in vogue for a very good reason among public relations practitioners, because it's a great way of doing something else that I think is really important, and that's establishing a good two-way relationship with your audience, creating a space where you can understand what's on your audience's mind, your stakeholders' mind, your employees, your customers, whomever your audiences are, understanding them better. The fundamental, one of the fundamental predictors of success, I think, in tough economic times of a company's future is the strength of its relationships with those who are most important to its business.